Hello guys, Mind Emerging Mind here. We're here with another revenge review on the new revenge sweater they just released, called the pinstripe terry hoodie, pinstripe terry hoodie, something like that. Yeah, I'll put the description down to the actual, you know, where I bought it from and all that. But here we're gonna do a little review on it. It just came in literally today on Tuesday. I had no notification on it. They didn't update me on anything on the USPS app at all, so it was kind of annoying, but it finally came in out of nowhere and I'm freaking happy about that. And I guess I'll show you the packaging and the sticker it came with. So first I'll show you the sticker. The sticker is this right here. It's some type of I don't know, is that Jesus or something, and some other people. I don't really know much about religion or, like, you know, like facts and history. But it says fuck life and fuck feelings, it says right there, close to them. Yeah, right there. It's not bad of a sticker. It's better than the other one I got that said the revenge, like the revenge logo, the fuck Vetmont's style one. It didn't have this gloss look to it. It was more matte, you know, fragile looking. But this looks cool. Eh, put it back. I'll put it in my sticker collection like I always do, so yeah. Let's get to the sweater now. First, the packaging, actually. The packaging is actually really nice now. It says revenge across it, sideways, actually. It's gotta be upwards, you know, because that's the top. But it says revenge, and I actually complained about the packaging in the first video. If you look back on my videos, I said, man, the packaging is really cheap. But now it's like a decent package, and it has a revenge print on it, which is pretty cool. So yeah, now let's open the package. And it's a Ziploc. Well, not a Ziploc, but it's like a sandwich bag, pretty much. But it's pretty cool. It's reusable. Some bags, like Supreme, you would think have a reusable bag, but they kind of do, but not really. So here's the hoodie in all of its glory. So as you can see, revenge is humongous on this one. The old hoodies from when they collabed with XXXTentacion were not this big. It was sort of smaller. This almost takes up the whole entire body of the hoodie. And also the black on this revenge logo is not super dark. It's light in a way. It's kind of like a charcoal in bright lighting. On camera it might look really, really black, but in reality it's not that way. It's actually very charcoal-y. I'll get close to the textures. It's a 3D print or a puff print, and it's really nice and thick, and you can see there's lines going through because it pretty much puffs, and when the light shines on it, or I think, like, I don't know how they exactly do it, but they put it like in a dark area and it starts to get thicker. It's not thicker right away, so it literally takes on the hoodie's texture, which is fine, and it looks pretty cool. So let's open it up. And then here's a French Terry hoodie, actually, first. It's really big, actually. It's actually really big, wow. And nice and thick. And you cannot feel the textures. It is just, if you look closely, I mean, I think you could sort of feel the texture, but to be honest, it's probably just ink. And it's pretty cool, though. And then here's a Revenge logo and a hoodie. It's back to the old school version. They're not using the electric one, or the, what do you call it, they're not using the lightning or scribble, you know, revenge logo again for the tags. And it says double X large. He said this is a new and improved fit, so it's like a normal hoodie, and it says it's slightly oversized, so I guess you could go down a size for a closer fit if you want, if you buy this on Grail, but I would not recommend it. I just buy your normal size. But yeah, let's really open this hoodie now. Jeez, that was a stupid. That was a stupid opening. Jeez. Okay, let's just keep taking it out. Here we go. Here that is. And that is. Alright, good. Now I know it's really. I can't really see the whole hoodie in the camera, so let's see what I can do. This is good as it gets, I guess. Alright, yeah, there it is, pretty much in all glory. The camera on the iPhone, and it's iPhone 6, I know I should upgrade, and I probably am soon. Not too soon, but eventually. But this hoodie, it looks like it bulks out on the edges, kind of like like wedges in a way. Like it just, it like stretches out and it kind of comes in like this. It's not a straight hoodie like they used to make them. I guess for every Kill All Revenge logo hoodie, they're gonna make it bulk out on the bottom for extra space and oversized fit. There's a front pocket. It's really big and nice, and the fabric feels sort of thin, but it's not like bad or anything. It just feels sort of like a napkin in a way. Like, look at the texture, see them? It almost seems like a towel texture, which is pretty interesting. And then if you go in the hoodie, it has this more texture feel to it. And it's not bad. It's actually gonna keep you warm in the winter when it gets colder. And then here is the sleeve. And it says in, like the usual, it says Revenge is in the creator's hand. In red, and it's a puff print as well. It's really nice and it feels good. And yeah, that's pretty much the front. It doesn't have a crop to bottom either, so it's like a regular hoodie now. Hope you know that, for this one at least. The other ones were cropped still on the website. Let's turn it around, because there's also another logo. Logo. That's just the signature Revenge logo right here. The one besides the Kill All logo. So here it is. Here's a skull with an R, standing for, you know, Revenge. Pretty much this, that's just there, you know, for an extra look and all. And it's really thick back here too. Actually, the skull is really thick, and the R is too, really nice. I don't really wash my Revenge hoodies because I'm super scared of this fabric, or I mean not this fabric, but this material just like melting or ripping up. I'm gonna try to keep this hoodie as very clean as possible, so it'll last a long time. But this hoodie is really nice. It's white. Be careful for stains. Don't wear this to restaurants. I really recommend that. Do not wear this to restaurants or out to eat if you want to keep it in perfect condition. Only wear it when you're going out shopping, or if you go, like, let's say on a road trip. Don't wear this hoodie in the car either. I would literally take it off when you're in the car ride and put it back on when you get out, because you know the seat of the car might rip up this fabric, or main fabric. Always see that the freaking material, you know. So be careful about that. And for authenticity, let's see if there's any more taggings. And you can see it inside the hoodie. No, it doesn't have any more taggings. They usually do, but I don't see anything. They usually have like a tag on telling you how to wash the hoodie and take care of it. But I mean, it's pretty common. It shows you on the website, so makes sense. See if inside the pockets, is there anything? Doesn't look like it. Nope, just the one tag on the collar area. So yeah. But this hoodie was really, really, really exclusive when it came in. Well, I mean, when you bought it, apparently. That's what Garrett said. So yeah. I guess I'll compare another hoodie with this one real fast. So I'll be back. So both of these hoodies, here they are. And the material, let's see. The pocket on this one, on the Revenge Ski Mask collab one with the Scribble Revenge logo, is more of a plush feel, and it's actually thicker, I say. And then the new one is sort of thinner and it feels more rough, but it's probably not a bad material, I wouldn't think. And then when it comes to let's see, the logo density and, you know, how it is, how it feels and all. So let's see. Okay, yeah, so the difference between the logos on the the texture and the stiffness and all that I just said, this one has a way thicker puff print or ink or whatever it is made of than this one. This one's thinner, it feels more rubbery. This one feels more rough and not so rubbery. And then this hoodie actually doesn't have any eyelets, or we call those things right there that the strings usually pop out of. This one has none at all, because this is a totally new fleece, he said. This is a totally new fleece, and if you bring it down to the bottom, one's cropped and one isn't. The new one isn't cropped, and the new one, the old one's cropped, new one's not. And this one, you got the back print of Ski Mask, you know, screaming and stuff like that, like kind of like the X one. And then this one, He just has original Revenge logo, or, you know, like their signature thing. But yeah, that's pretty much it on the hoodies. There's one more thing coming exactly today. I just don't know when. It's supposed to be the Young Lean Converse, and I'm probably gonna end up doing a review on those tomorrow morning. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and give it a like, thumbs down, put anything in the comment section what you think about them. You can ask me questions about the hoodie, subscribe if you want, and that'll be pretty much it. And oh yeah, the retail price was $130 after shipping and everything. Well, it depends where you live as well. If you live overseas, it's gonna be a lot more expensive. If you live in America, it's just $10. It's crazy, I know, but that's just the way shit rolls. So yeah, peace out.